Welcome to Grab and Go Info. In this tutorial, we will talk about hyperparameter tuning and regularization for time series model using profit in Python. You will learn what are the hyperparameters for a profit time series model. Among all the hyperparameters, what hyperparameters should be tuned and what hyperparameters are better not to be tuned. Among all the hyperparameters that should be tuned, what hyperparameters should be tuned automatically versus manually. How are hyperparameter tunings related to regularization? How does data transformation impact the model performance? If you are not familiar with profit, please check out my previous tutorial time series forecasting of Bitcoin prices using profit, multivariate time series forecasting with seasonality and holiday effect using profit, and three ways for multiple time series forecasting using profit. Let's get started. In step 0, we will provide an overview of all the hyperparameters for a profit model. The hyperparameters are divided into three groups. The first group contains hyperparameters that are suitable for automatic tuning. We can specify a list of values and do a grid search for the best value combination. For more information about grid search, please refer to my previous tutorial Hyperparameter Tuning for XGBoost. The second group contains hyperparameters that are suitable for manual tuning. A human needs to make a judgment on what hyperparameter value to use based on knowledge about data and business. The third group contains the hyperparameters that are better left untuned with the default values. There are four hyperparameters that are suitable to be tuned automatically using grid search. Change point prior scale is probably the most impactful parameter according to the profit documentation. It determines the scale of the change at the time series trend change point. It is an L1 lasso regularization penalty term. To learn more about regularization, please refer to my previous tutorial lasso versus ridge versus elastic net regularization for classification model. When the scale is too small, the trend does not change much at the change point, and the model tends to underfit. This is because the variance caused by the trend change is likely to be considered as noise with a small change point prior scale value. When the scale is too large, the trend changes a lot at the change point, and the model tends to overfit. The variance caused by noise is considered to be part of the trend. The default value for change point prior scale is 0.05, and the recommended tuning range is 0.001 to 0.5. This hyperparameter is usually tuned on a log scale. Seasonality prior scale controls the magnitude of the seasonality fluctuation. It is an L2 ridge regularization penalty term. When the scale is too small, the magnitude of the seasonality shrinks to a very small value. When the scale is too large, the magnitude of the seasonality allows very large fluctuations. The default value for seasonality prior scale is 10, meaning that no regularization is applied. The recommended tuning range is 0.01 to 10, where a smaller value corresponds to a smaller magnitude of seasonality. This hyperparameter is usually tuned on a log scale. Holidays prior scale determines the scale of holiday effects and is very similar to the seasonality prior scale. The default value is 10, meaning that no regularization is applied. The recommended tuning range is also 0.01 to 10, where a smaller value corresponds to a smaller magnitude of holidays. Seasonality mode has two options, additive and multiplicative. The additive model adds trend, seasonality, and other effects together when making predictions. It is appropriate for the time series models with relatively constant seasonal variation over time. The multiplicative model multiplies trend, seasonality, and other effects together when making predictions. It is appropriate for the time series models with increasing or decreasing seasonal variation over time. Some hyperparameters need to be evaluated by a human based on business knowledge or data observations for manual tuning. Change point range is a value between 0 and 1. Indicating the percentage of historical data that allow a trend change. The default value is 0.8, meaning that the first 80% of the data allows trend changes, and the last 20% of the data does not allow a trend change. This is because there are not enough data at the end of the time series to identify a trend change with confidence. The person who builds the model can increase or decrease the value manually by examining the time series shape and model performance for the last 20% of data. Growth has two options, linear and logistic. The default value is linear, and it can be manually changed to logistic if there is a known growth saturating point. Change points manually specifying the dates of change points. The default value is none, which allows the model to automatically identify and place the change points on the trend. However, if there are any known events such as the rebranding of the business, the corresponding date can be manually added. Yearly seasonality has three options: auto, true, and false. The default is auto, which automatically turns the yearly seasonality on when there are at least two cycles of data. We can manually set yearly seasonality to be true to force the yearly seasonality if there are less than 2 years of data. Yearly seasonality is usually not set to false, because it's more effective to leave it on and turn down the seasonal effects by tuning seasonality prior scale. Weekly seasonality and daily seasonality can be handled in the same way as the yearly seasonality. Holidays takes in a data frame with specified holidays and special events. We can manually include or exclude holidays or events, or change the number of days impacted by the holiday to tune this hyperparameter. The magnitude of the holiday effects should be tuned by holidays prior scale. There are five hyperparameters that should not be tuned, and change points is the number of change points on the trend. The default value is 25. Rather than increasing or decreasing the number of change points, the profit documentation suggested to focusing increasing or decreasing the flexibility at those trend changes, which is done with change point prior scale. Interval width determines the uncertainty interval for the predictions. The default value is 0.8, meaning that the prediction upper bound ahat upper and the prediction lower bound ahat lower are based on the 80% uncertainty interval. Interval width does not impact the model prediction, so there is no need to tune this hyperparameter. Uncertainty samples is the number of samples used for uncertainty interval calculation. The default value is 1000. And increasing the value decreases the variance of the uncertainty interval. This hyperparameter does not impact the model prediction, so there is no need to tune it. MCMC samples is an integer that determines if the model uses a full Bayesian inference or a maximum a posterior for model training and prediction. When it's greater than zero, a full Bayesian inference with the specified number of MCMC samples will be used. Bayesian inference usually needs at least 1,000 samples to get reasonable results. When it equals to zero, a maximum a posterior estimation will be used. The default value for MCMC samples is zero, indicating that maximum a posterior estimation is used by default. The profit documentation suggests leaving this hyperparameter unchanged. Stand backend needs to be specified when both piston and CMD stampy backends are set up. This hyperparameter does not impact model training and prediction, so there is no need to tune it. In the first step, we will install and import libraries. iFinance is the Python package for pulling stock data from Yahoo Finance. Profit is the package for the time series model. After installing iFinance and Profit, they are imported into the notebook. We also import pandas and NumPy for data processing, Seaborn and Matplotlib for visualization, and EITR tools, cross-validation, and performance metrics for hyperparameter tuning. To get the code for this tutorial, please check out my blog post on Medium.com. I will put the link in the video description. Medium.com is my most referenced website for data science and machine learning. It charges $5 per month for full access. I have been a Medium.com member for many years, and that's the best $5 I spent every month. If you would like to support me and buy me a cup of coffee, please use the link in the video description to join the Medium membership at no additional cost. If you prefer not to join, you can still read the post because there are a couple of free posts each month for everyone to read. Okay, let's continue. The second step pulls stock data from Yahoo Finance API. We will pull 2 years of daily data from the beginning of 2020 to the end of 2021. Start date equals 2020-0102 because January 1st is a holiday, and there is no stock data on holidays and weekends. End date equals 2022-0101 because iFinance excludes the end date, so we need to add 1 day to the last day of the data end date. The goal of the time series model is to predict the closing price of Google's stock, so Google's ticker GOOG is used for pulling the data. Profit requires at least two columns as inputs, a DS column and a Y column. The DS column has the time information. Currently, we have the date as the index, so we reset the index and rename date to DS. The Y column has the time series values. In this example, because we are predicting Google's closing price, the column name for the price is changed to Y. Using .info, we can see that the dataset has 505 records and there are no missing values. Next, let's visualize the closing prices of the two tickers using Seaborn, and add the legend to the plot using Matplotlib. We can see that the price for Google increased a lot starting in late 2020, and almost doubled in late 2021. In step 3, we will build a baseline model using the default profit hyperparameters. Profit automatically fits daily, weekly, and yearly seasonalities if the time series is more than two cycles long. The model information shows that the yearly seasonality and the daily seasonality are disabled. The daily seasonality is disabled because we do not have sub-daily time series. The yearly seasonality is disabled although we have 2 years of data because there are no stock price data on holidays and weekends. So we have less than 365 data points for each year. Next, let's do cross-validation for the baseline model to get the model performance. Profit has a cross-validation function to automate the comparison between the actual and the predicted values. Model equals baseline model specifies the model name. Initial equals 200 days means the initial model will be trained on the first 200 days of data. Period equals 30 days means 30 days will be added to the training dataset for each additional model. Horizon equals 30 days means that the model forecasts the next 30 days. When only horizon is given, profit defaults initial to be triple the horizon, and period to be half of the horizon. Parallel equals processes enables parallel processing for cross-validation. When the parallel cross-validation can be done on a single machine, processes provide the highest performance. For larger problems, Dask can be used to do cross-validation on multiple machines. Based on the output from the cross-validation, we can get the model performance using the method performance metrics. The model performance metrics are calculated using a rolling window. The average performance metrics values are calculated for each value of the horizon. Since we have the horizon value of 30 days, there will be 30 average values, one for each day. Rolling window determines the window size, which is the percentage of forecasted data points to include in the calculation. Rolling window equals 0 computes performance metrics separately for each horizon. Rolling window equals 0.1 is the default value, which computes performance metrics using about 10% of the predictions in each window. Rolling window equals 1 computes performance metrics using all the forecasted data. We are using rolling window equals 1 in this tutorial to get a single performance metric number. Rolling window lesser than 0 computes each data point without averaging. Profit provides 6 commonly used performance metrics. Mean squared error sums up the squared difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. Root mean square error takes the square root of the mean square error. Mean absolute error sums up the absolute difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. Mean absolute percentage error sums up the absolute percentage difference between actual and prediction and is divided by the number of predictions. MAPE is independent of the magnitude of data, so it can be used to compare different forecasts, but it's undefined when the actual value is zero. Median absolute percentage error is similar to MAPE. The difference is that it calculates the median instead of taking the average of the absolute percentage difference. Symmetric mean absolute percentage error is similar to MAP. The difference is that when calculating absolute percentage error, the denominator is the actual value for MAP and the average of the actual and predicted value for SMAP. We can see that e-baseline model using default hyperparameters has 4.45% mean absolute percentage error, meaning that the predictions are 4.45% off the actual values. In step 4, we will check the hyperparameters for manual tuning. Change point range will be increased from 0.8 to 0.9 to see if there is a trend change near the end of the time series. This is because the shape of the time series seems to flatter starting around October of 2021 based on human observation. Growth is kept at the default value linear because there is no saturating point for the stock price data. Change points is kept at the default value is none, which allows the model to automatically identify and place the change points on the trend. This is because there are not any known big events that are likely to impact the Google stock prices in the time range used for the model. Yearly seasonality is kept at the automated value of false because we do not have more than 2 cycles of yearly data for the model training. Weekly seasonality is kept at the automated value of true because we have more than 2 cycles of weekly data. Daily seasonality is kept at the automated value of false because we do not have sub-daily data. Holidays takes in a data frame with specified holidays and special events. We can manually include 2 special events, COVID start and Super Bowl. The manually changed hyperparameters will be evaluated one by one. If the change improves the model performance, we will keep the change. Otherwise, we will switch back to the default values. Firstly, let's increase change point range from 0.8 to 0.9 to see if there is a trend change near the end of the time series. The mean absolute percentage error from cross-validation is 5.13%, which is higher than the baseline model of 4.45%, indicating that we should not increase the value of change point range. Next, let's create 2 special events, COVID start and Super Bowl. For the COVID start event, we set the date to be March 15th of 2020, then extend the event to 15 days before and 15 days after using lower window and upper window separately. For the Super Bowl event, We set the date in 2020 and 2021 separately, and extend the event to 7 days before and 1 day after. Then the two events are concatenated together to one data frame called events. After adding the special events, the mean absolute percentage error from cross-validation is 4.64%, which is higher than the baseline model of 4.45%, indicating that the special events are not predictive of the stock prices. Therefore, we should not include special events in the model. There are four hyperparameters that are suitable to be tuned automatically using grid search, change point prior scale, seasonality prior scale, holidays prior scale, and seasonality mode. Holidays prior scale is not applicable because there is no holiday or special events included in the model. We will use grid search to find the best values for the other three hyperparameters. Firstly, four values for change point prior scale, five values for seasonality prior scale, and two values for seasonality mode are used to set up the parameter grid. Then, all combinations of parameters are created and saved in a variable called allparams. MAPS is an empty list created for storing the mean absolute percentage error for each combination of parameters. After that, we loop through each parameter combination to build a time series model and save the cross-validation performance results in the list called MAPS. Finally, we get the best parameters based on the minimum value of mean absolute percentage error and build a new model using the best parameters. We can see that the best parameters are change point prior scale equals 0.05, seasonality prior scale equals 1, and seasonality mode equals additive. The mean absolute percentage error from cross-validation is 4.42% for the model with the best parameters, which is better than the baseline model of 4.45%. The profit model documentation mentions some hyperparameters are best tuned in log scale. In step 6, we will transform the data to the log form and then do the automatic hyperparameter tuning. Firstly, a copy of the modeling data is created with the name data log. Then, the log scale data is created by taking the natural log of the stock prices. After that, the original stock prices are deleted and the log scale stock prices are renamed to Y. Lastly, the new log scale data is used for grid search, and the best parameters are used for the final model. The mean absolute percentage error from cross-validation is 0.67% for the log scale model with the best parameters, which is much better than the baseline model of 4.45%. If you have made it this far, you probably find the information in this tutorial helpful. Please click the like button and subscribe to the channel to get notified when I publish new videos like this. To learn more about time series forecasting, please click the YouTube playlist on the screen now. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.